Hi, this is Natalie with The Fifth Journey.
I'm Valerie.
And we are going to make some fire starters. So what you need to have is an egg carton. Make sure it is cardboard. You don't want the styrofoam kind. And then we have been saving up lint from the dryer. And the other thing I've been saving up is the wax melt wax. So when I put them in our little tart warmer and the fragrance is all gone, I go ahead, let it cool, I pop it out, and then I throw it in a bag. So I have several of these ready.
Yep.
And then we are going to melt them down. We're going to put the lint inside of the egg cartons, and then we're going to pour the wax over the top. So if you're going to be doing this with any young children, make sure that there is an adult with them and that you're helping with them. Have goggles. We do have goggles. We have gloves, so everybody is good and safe. We are using a makeshift double boiler. I have an old pot that I'm using. I have a can, a large can, that I have made a little bit of a funnel, and that will just be tossed when we're done with this. And then I have a silicone trivet in the bottom. You can also use some shims or something, but you want to make sure that your inside pan or tin or whatever you're using is away from the direct heat. Make sure that your surfaces are covered with a wax paper to keep everything protected, and we'll go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn the heat on, and then we're going to fill the fire starter. So go ahead and put a glove on. And then we'll put the goggles on you. And I'm gonna have you place the wax in here. Is it too big?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna break it.
Here, I'll break it. Okay. Set this aside. Be careful not to drop it. Now, since you don't know, you may know if it's a soy wax, you want to make sure that you're not getting this too hot, no higher than 170 degrees. If it's a beeswax, that can go higher, but you don't want to get it too hot. You need to know what the flash point is of your wax so you don't get it too hot. And it will melt down. How's it going?
Good.
Good.
One more?
Okay. Good job. All right, I'm going to go ahead and set these aside.
And
this is why we have goggles on, because when they look up over the top. Yep, it's going to melt pretty fast. So we're going to go ahead and put this over the heat.
It's bubbling.
Yep. And these are kitchen gloves. And they're not oven mitts, but they do have a little bit of heat protection. So I'm not putting my hands in the boiling water. All right. I'm going to put our egg carton on. I have a tray with some wax paper on it. I'm going to bring it over here. Go ahead and take the gloves off. And this may make a little bit of a mess because it is lint. Okay, you can take the goggles off because this is going to take a little bit to melt. And all you're going to do is you're going to take your lint and you're going to smash it in as much as you can. Yeah, well, it doesn't matter if that's mine. You're going to smash as much as you can into each one of the little spots. There you go. Smash it in. Try and keep everything over the top, because if you're doing anything on the floor, all that dust and lint is going to get on the floor. So we want to keep it over the top of the countertops. Now, if you do not have a glass cooktop like I do, and if you have a gas stove or you have the kind that have the grates on top, you want to make sure to have something covered, because this is super easy to clean up. When I'm done, I can, if I drop some wax on, I can just take a razor blade once it's cool and scrape it off. It comes right off. But you may have a bigger mess. Or if you have a camp stove, that works perfectly. And some of this lint is very glittery. You must have washed something with glitter in it. So we have these all shoved in. We're just going to wait on that wax to melt. Yes. Okay, go ahead and get our lint put away for another time. Yeah, see, it's hardly melted at all.
It's almost done.
No, it's got a long ways to go. It's barely melted at all. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and pause the video So you're not sitting here waiting and watching us melt the wax, right?
Yeah.
Because that's kind of boring to watch, isn't it? Yep.
Yep.
Yep, see, it's got a long way to go.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll be back in just a minute, okay?
Okay.
We're back. It's been about 5 minutes. It really didn't take too long, but these are mainly, since I was using them in our wax melt, it's already a soft wax, so they are almost done. But, and I think this was a mix of Christmas and fall fragrances, so it smells pretty good, even though most of the fragrance was used up. So once this is done, then I will pour them in here. We'll let it harden, and then she's going to go ahead and cut them out, and then you can use these in campfires or what you need to do to start using it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So,
not that much.
Start a fire.
I can't really see it.
Slide it.
Smells good.
Mm-hmm. Now again, hot wax is very hot, so be very, very careful. Right?
Yeah.
Right. You don't play with candles, right? Right.
If you play with a light, if you play with one that has been lighted.
Lit.
Lit?
Mm-hmm.
You do not want to mess around with it.
No, correct.
It would be okay if it wasn't lit.
Yes.
But if it was, it wouldn't.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Right. Now, even as an adult, you don't want to put your face right over the top of it. One little piece in there. I'm almost done. I'm going to go ahead and turn the heat off because there's no point in having it on right now. Because the water will still stay nice and warm. You want to mix that, stir that for me? Nice and gentle. Good.
I feel that piece.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's a little piece. Now don't knock the jar around. So hard for the jar to move around. Almost done. I think it's done.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's not. There's one little piece
you
in
see?
There. Kind of hard to see. Well, there's a little piece in there.
Yeah. I saw it.
Almost. Good job.
Okay.
Okay, can go ahead and stir it.
Mm-hmm.
Good job. Look at you. Okay. Can you go ahead and hold that in place? With the one you have your glove on, so make sure you hold it with your gloved hand. There we go. Okay, I'm going to turn this around. Get a good grip on it.
There.
Okay, we're going to actually slide it over here because that's a good chance I'm probably going to spill.
Yep.
All right, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
There it comes. And it just soaks right in.
Uh-oh, just spilled.
Mm-hmm.
Really hot.
See it soaking in?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead and move your hand a little bit. And we have used about half the wax, so I'm going to put this back in there. And then we're going to let this one sit, and we're actually going to go ahead and do another one while this is cooling, and then we'll come back and cut them up, and we'll be done. So we'll be right back. All right. So we poured that in, and we have enough wax to do another one, so go ahead and take that, and I want you to rip, go ahead and open it up, and can you tear that part off? Good job. There you go. Okay, we'll put this in the recycling. Put that one.
I got some stuff on there.
Well, that can stay on.
Okay.
Or we can cut it off later. Anyway. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and fill that side up with lint. Do it over the top. Now, this is definitely something I would use for your own home personal use. I wouldn't give this as gifts because you're using your own dryer lint. So I personally wouldn't want to get fire starters from somebody made from their dryer lint. But, you know, when you do your own stuff, then that's totally fine. We can put some more in that one. Let's see, squish them down in there. Oh, that one doesn't have very much in it. Go ahead and put more in that one.
Two?
I'm going to put some more in that one. This one could use some more.
That? One more piece?
Yeah, maybe some more in these two. And squish that one in a little bit. Good job. Okay, pull it up. So see how we spilled right here?
Yeah.
This one's already getting cool. The nice thing about the wax paper is I can just peel it off. Let me peel it off. And then just put it back in. Good job. Oh, careful. Okay. Alright, good job. Now you want to give it a stir? Still pretty melted, but we just put those little pieces in. Good job. All right, and we're gonna do the second pour. Good job. Good thinking. Okay, hold it. Let's move it this way so you can see.
Yeah. Okay. I'll just hold.
Okay. There you go. Good job. Okay, we're gonna slide it over here. Oh, sorry. It kind of looks like snow cones, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Fuzzy? Snow cones.
Really fuzzy. And dirty.
And dirty. And linty.
Imagine eating that.
Ooh, that'd be gross.
Yeah.
You don't eat this.
It doesn't matter for a goat.
Oh, okay. We are out of wax. We're going to set this aside to cool, and I'm going to go ahead and pick out the little pieces of wax that have fallen into the water. Once everything is cooled down, we've cleaned up, we'll tear the egg carton pieces apart and put them in a bag to use till later. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.